Todd with the Reason Files. We have received reports over the weekend that a high number of people have cut ties with Faithful Word Baptist Church. Also, we're getting reports that three or four families were booted from Revival Baptist Church by Patrick Boyle. Also, it should be noted that this took place in Jacksonville and the families were told not to return. Reason Files was unable to get a list of the people booted from Revival in Jacksonville, but we believe that Jersey Joe or Jacksonville Joe or whatever they want to call him was one of the members booted from Jacksonville. Interesting that Ben the Baptist is not reporting this on his channel. Normally he'll have some smart comments that somebody took out the trash. Speaking of trash, let's take a little listen to what Jonathan Shelley said about trash here just recently.
Why in a lot of areas in the Bible, it's saying, if I take some trash and I roll it around with something that's good, is the good thing going to turn the trash into something that's great? Or is the trash going to turn the good thing into more trash? As soon as I drop something in the trash, it's trash. It doesn't matter how good it was before. Hey, if I have a nice piece of bread and then I drop in the trash, now it's trash. I'm not thinking like, oh, now the trash is reconcilable. Now it's recyclable. Let's drag all the good stuff out. No, it's saying dirty things make other things dirty. Clean things don't make things clean, okay?
With all that being said, Ben the Baptist, knowing the value of trash and knowing a hungry wolf would definitely eat trash, we'll see how long it is for these booted people make it to Fort Worth. Now let's listen to some of the falsehoods that Jonathan Shelley stated at the current Red Hot Preaching Conference. This clip here, he's referring to Adam Fannin, and I will clear all this up for the listeners.
Let me say this also about this freeloader. Whenever I was going to take over Stedfast Baptist Church, I texted this freeloader and I said, hey, give me all the financials that you have for the church. Receipts, the tithing ledger, expenses, just all the financial records, all the financial documents. Romero has that in Dallas.
Now, if Steven Anderson would have ran a competent investigation, and when Steven Anderson had Donnie Romero's cell phone in his possession, a wealth of information could have been discovered. Adam Fannin texted detailed information to Donnie Romero on the deposits of Stedfast Jacksonville. Also, these totals were printed in the church bulletin. Also, something called the bank statement would reflect if this was true or not. Steven Anderson and Jonathan Shelley had access to these records. Now we're going to hear Jonathan Shelley make references to Romero about 2015 transactions. This was way before Stedfast Jacksonville even came along. Let's listen.
How about this freeloader, Donnie Romero? Freeloader. Just attaching himself to other people and using them, despitefully using them, for his own personal advantage, his own personal glory. The guy was a freeloader. Subverting, taking advantage of people, telling them, hey, only tithe in cash. That's the best way to tithe. In fact, I don't even think you should give a check. Just everything in cash. Just keep giving as much cash as possible. Just cash, 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 cash. I wonder why he wants cash. You know, one of the interesting things it is, whenever I took over Stedfast and I finally got onto the bank records, you know what I noticed? There was zero cash deposits for Stedfast the last 6 months of him being the pastor there.
Zero cash deposits? How does that work? All these people that were giving cash all of a sudden stopped in Fort Worth. Okay, yeah, right. Let's continue listening to Jonathan Shelley talking about his investigation.
Financial records started at the beginning of 2015. And guess what's on the first statement? casino ATM charges. Freeloader, just taking advantage of people, just a hypocrite, one who's just a complete, just bloodsucker, just sucking from the congregation, taking advantage of them, ripping them off.
So Shelley did have the bank records from 2015 for Stedfast Fort Worth and the bank statements and records from Stedfast Jacksonville. And him and Steven Anderson were having trouble putting all this together. Why? I wish I could play the clip, but I cannot. A person inside Stedfast Fort Worth reported reason files that it was highly probable someone was in Stedfast Fort Worth and directing Jeff Futzler and friends what locations to visit. Of course, we're referring to casino locations. More specifically, casino bar locations that Utzler and friends were visiting. Let's take a listen to what Steven Anderson said yesterday.
No problem and just drink a soda, because I'm delivered. But the smart former alcoholic is never going to set foot in a bar. In fact, no one should set foot in a bar anyway. But I'm saying, especially an alcoholic, should stay super far away from that.
Amazing. Next time, call these guys. Reason files out.